We all expect our water to be clean, but you'd be surprised to know what may be coming out of your faucet. Most water treatment facilities were built before many of these contaminants were created, so the process wasn't designed to remove them. That's where environmental engineer Dr. Rachel Brennan of Penn State University enters the picture.
I went into engineering because I wanted to design things that people would use. So the fundamental difference, I think, between science and engineering is science studies things and figures stuff out, and engineers go out and apply it. So when we started working with Eco-machine processes, the ultimate goal is to get it out there and to use it.
Last summer, Dr. Brennan's research team built the newest Penn State Eco-machine, but instead of gears and circuits, constructed it out of duckweed, plants, and fungi. Here's how it works.
The wastewater comes in, it goes through a series of tanks and all these different life forms, and the effluent that we're getting out is clean. The second thing we noticed is when we tried to remove some of the nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus, we did this by adding duckweed. And then you can use duckweed for amending soils as a fertilizer to enable greater crop yields. You can use it as a feedstock amendment. And in some countries, people actually eat duckweed straight. In the lab side, we are exploring the use of the fungi for removing emerging contaminants.
The fungi produce enzymes naturally, which are able to break down the chemicals in the wastewater without the addition of extra chemicals and without the consumption of large amounts of energy.
This makes it ideal for use in developed communities or third world countries. In essence, the Eco-machine does what nature has been doing for millions of years. And while it's doubtful that there will ever be a limit to new contaminants in our water, it's inspiring to know that engineers like Dr. Brennan are creating solutions to solve these problems.
And the more that I work with these Eco-machine systems, the more I realize how much potential we have to do a variety of good things.
Penn State, inspiring engineering.